This tutorial will show you how to access the APA Psych Articles database and find peer-reviewed articles in psychology. APA Psych Articles has full-text articles from over 100 peer-reviewed journals published by the American Psychological Association and the Canadian Psychological Association, and it has articles that go as far back as 1894. To find APA Psych articles, go to the library's page and select Article Databases. From here, you can find the database by going alphabetically under A and scrolling down, or you can also select Subject, Psychology, and you can find it under Best Bets. Once you click on the database, you will be prompted to enter your Saddleback login information if you are off campus. Here's the homepage for APA Psych Articles. As you can see, this is a ProQuest product. It looks and feels very similar to the general ProQuest search page. However, unlike when we search the general ProQuest option, this option will only have articles that pertain to psychology. The main page defaults to a basic search. To do a basic search, you will enter keywords in the search bar. Let's do a search together to see how it works. I'm going to search for the following: ADHD and anxiety. Before I hit search, I'm going to select full text and peer-reviewed. My search has over 2,000 results. I can limit my search further by using the publication date limiter on the left-hand side. I'm going to limit my search to the last 5 years. Now the number has gone down to just over 1,000. This number tells me my search is still pretty wide and I should think about further defining the who, what, when, where, or why. In this case, I'm going to define the who as children. When I add the term children to my existing search limiters, we will see that the results narrow down. I have 894 results. I could further define the topic by defining the where, United States, and the what. Maybe I might want to be looking at educational outcomes or medication. Let's take a look at some of the articles that we see in our results. When I click on an article, I can see the abstract. That's the brief summary of the article here. Typically, it will show up in the web view. It's best to find the PDF on the left side of the page and use it to read the article because it's going to include all of the visuals, images, and graphs. It also includes page numbers. Here we can see 209, which are really important for your citations. Once I have found an article that I'd like to use, I need to remember to do two things. I need to save it and I need to cite it. To save the article, you can either email it to yourself here, you can download the PDF, or you can click on the icon with the three dots and you can see the options for cloud saving. You can select Google Drive or Microsoft OneDrive. I like this option the best because it makes keeping track of your sources so easy. Any additional articles you save during your search will be in a folder called APA Psych Articles. Now we can't forget our second item. We need the citation. Click on the icon with the quotes and select the most recent version of APA. You can copy and paste this into your Works Cited page. These built-in citation tools make things easier, but they are not perfect. You don't want to have points deducted on your papers. Use our checklist on the APA LibGuide to double check your citations. If you have any questions about APA Psych Articles or any other research questions, please do not hesitate to ask a librarian. Stop by the reference desk on the third floor of the LRC, or let us help you remotely via chat, text, or Zoom.